That'll get you some perks. All right, Final Fantasy X, let's do this. We got about 2 hours and 15 minutes. I'll go ahead and update the schedule to reflect it as well. I think so. It's either Marstead or Marstead TK. My wife might have a save on here, we'll see. Man, get on the FF14 train, Nulu. We want you. Yeah, probably. It's either Marstead or Marstead TK. You can try sending it to either. I don't know. I'm only ever on it to play on stream, so. Pretty excited to play this game again. It's been a while. This is my wife's first Final Fantasy. He hasn't bought it yet, Kami. I was gonna distribute it to Matt and Hapax. We just got Chaos and buddies. Okay, I'm gonna skip this, even though it's very pretty, because it plays it again at the beginning of the game, and I remember this. Do experts for grid, why not? Sounds good, man. I made that mistake multiple times in Final Fantasy X where I let the Tiz Anakin music play at the beginning and watch it, the credits, and then you start the game and it does it again. So this game opens with the storytelling trope in media res, which means in the middle of it. So this is the middle of the story-ish, and most of the game is going to be in flashback with Tidus as a narrator. They've gotten much better, Nulu. I don't know. I felt similarly about it during 1.0, but everything since Yoshi-P took over and they revamped it has been outstanding. It's been a mostly straight line of progress. This looks quite good in the HD version. I needed some shaking out of it to even try it after hearing all the bad stuff about 1.0. How they were, like, not able to hold a subscriber base.
Listen to my story. This may be our last chance.
If you don't have the time for it, that's a good reason not to play. Man, Final Fantasy X. And Joe, man, you haven't even hit the meat yet. You're still eating your vegetables. Right, Joe, man. This is the, I think, the only occurrence of the Prelude in Final Fantasy X. Famous arpeggiated Final Fantasy song. Man, keep an eye out for that little kid in a hood. They're gonna tell us who he is way later in the game, like 70% of the way through. But it's kind of a nice benefit to someone who's played the game before. We'll be keeping this as a spoiler-free playthrough for people who haven't played 10 before, but I'll point out stuff you should pay attention to. Because there, you would never notice that otherwise. Yeah, the background's really pretty. They kind of redid. There are still some pre-rendered backgrounds. This is the first Final Fantasy that does fully 3D environments with pre-rendered or painted backgrounds.
Can I have your autograph?
Clever way to learn character's name. Do we want to keep him Titus? I can throw up a stream poll for this real quick. Been a while. Alright, if people have ideas for Titus's name, throw them out in chat and I'll do it as an auction rather than a... Or we'll do it as a poll rather than an auction so that people can pool their votes together. Titus. I'll put Andrea's requested name in there even though she's not here. Titus. You make me pronounce it Titus. Y'all are jerks. See, the other thing that Andrea would name him would be Tyler. Like T-Y... L-E with an accent mark on it, R. That's what she named him in her playthrough. She thought he looked like a Tyler. Right, Cloud Reaver. Cloud, Squall, and Titus. I guess Zidane got left alone. Superman, Buckle Bro. Alright, I think I got enough names here. You only get to vote for one thing, but you can put as many sphere points behind your vote as you want. So you can type exclamation point SP to see how many SP you have. When you type vote, so like if you did vote 100, you would be voting for option 1 and putting 100 sphere points behind it. Titus. Man, sounds like Titus is gonna happen. I like Buckle Bro, Cloudier. Zipperman for 100. I'll go ahead and start the timer. I think most folks have had a chance to vote here. Buckle Bro, man. Looks like Titus is currently taking it with 200. Buckle Bro has 101. Looks like it's going to be Titus. you missed the boat, Chaos, but I don't think you would have tied it. Titus it is. Good suggestions, guys. They call him Titus in Kingdom Hearts 1. One of the voice actors says that. They do say Titus correctly. In Kingdom Hearts 2. I'm just being a dick, though. Like, I don't know how he's actually supposed to be pronounced. Like, how is his name Romanized in Japanese? Okay. Is it T-A-I, Taitus, or Titus?
What seat?
East block in the front row! Fifth from the right!
Got it.
Nice, Cloud Reaver. You gotta have belt straps, you have to have asymmetrical shoulder pads, you gotta have a pendant.
Can you sign this?
No problem.
Please?
Alrighty.
Me too!
Take it easy.
Hear me say Titus every time.
Well, gotta go. Cheer for me.
2, 3.
Teach us. Yeah, see, so.
Hey, I got a game to play.
Then teach us after.
Maybe tonight.
You camp tonight.
I mean,
true deal, Purple Hood kid. Teed! That would be pretty good. That's kind of a weird little gesture they're doing there. Blitzball's pretty sweet, yeah. They've joked about bringing it into Final Fantasy XIV. We'll see. Yeah, so you have this like string of like mercenary or warrior or thief main characters in Final Fantasy, and then like you get an athlete. Basically a water soccer player. That's Titus's dad, Jekt.
I was in a coffee shop running away from home when I heard the news. Our hero, Jekt, gone. Vanished into thin air. My dad must have been his biggest fan. I knew how sad he'd be. Heck, we all were that day. Zanar, I says to myself,
this is like
what
a
are you thinking?
Radio.
I went running straight back home. We sat up talking
an announcer
about
for
Jekt
the game
all
talking
night.
About
my dad and I never talked so much. Whoa. Didn't mean to reminisce, folks. Anyway, 10 years later, the Jekt Memorial Cup tournament is today. The two teams that have won through to the finals are, of course, the Abes from A East and the Duggles from C South. I know there's a lot of people out there today to see the star of the Abes. In just 1 year, he's become the team's number one player. He's Jekt's blood and the new hope of Blitzball. What kind of super play will he show us today? Will we see his father's legendary shot? I don't think I'm the only one.
I agree, Joe, man. It's cool storytelling. I can give everyone in chat 5 sure points if you catch me saying Titus instead of Titus.
Make way, make way!
Put you guys in charge of tracking that. Through, if you hear me say Titus after this example of me saying Titus,
I'm gonna be late.
Call me out and I'll give everyone in chat 5 sure points every time it happens. Oh man, awesome graphics. If you're alt-tab, you should tab in and watch this cutscene. Yeah, they didn't re-record this. This song is called Otherworld. Uematsu's take on death metal. That's some fun, very Englishy lyrics. Oh man, Orin! I think it's my favorite Final Fantasy character. Kind of a cliche favorite Final Fantasy character. I don't care. He's awesome. Right, Cloud Reaver. Yeah, Cloud Reaver, I agree. The whole thing with the one arm that he like saves until he has to fight. And the sake he carries around with him. I don't know. He's got just a really cool aesthetic. I like his voice actor a lot too. I was disappointed in Kingdom Hearts 2, they didn't get this in this sector. Exactly, Joe Man. It's very English-y, it's awesome. Closing the blitzball ring and melt. HD release, that's a pretty cool looking statue right there in front of him. They put some work into this.
Orin! What are you doing here?
I was waiting for you.
What are you talking about?
Tidus. It's voiced by James Arnold Taylor. He's a pretty prolific voice actor. He's voiced Leonardo, Ninja Turtles, quite a bit. He's also the current voice of Fred Flintstone. Yeah, sounds good, dude. I'm sure I'll be back. I try to go back about once a year or so. We were last there in April. You can take an educated guess at who this purple-hooded kid is if you look at his back.
It begins.
What?
Don't cry.
Hey, D-Rock, how you doing, man?
What the? Hey, wait!
Hey, Tico.
Hey, not this way.
Graphics again, I think. Graphics.
We called it sin.
Hey, go for it, Joe Man. I don't know, man. The atmosphere at the beginning of 10 is pretty sweet. You like, you have no idea what's going on. Like, we called it sin. Like, what does that mean? Past tense? Great build-up. The main plot device is pretty easy to figure out a little bit later on. But they do a good job of making you feel smart when you figure it out. A little smarter than Tidus, anyway.
A gift from Jekt.
You can always play 14 on stream, Joe Man. People like to watch a blind playthrough.
I hope you know how to use it.
Let's go. So I think this might be... this might be heretical, but I think I like this battle system more than any other Final Fantasies. I don't really like ATB. I've grown up with ATB, and I live with it. I enjoy those games, but like, I love the pure turn-based style of this, where you have as much time as you want to make your move. You notice in the top right corner, it gives you perfect information. You know exactly when everyone's turn is going to occur before you make your decision, so it feels a lot more tactical. That makes sense, Joe Man. I hear your point. Yeah, I only ever stream the main story of the game. Any of my dicking around I do, I don't stream.
Don't bother going after all of them. Cut the ones that matter and run.
Cut the ones that matter. Here they're teaching us you don't always have to kill all the enemies in the battle. Yeah, it's cool. So, like, you know, if you cast haste on your party members, the little turn indicator in the top right gives you a preview of what that's going to do for you. Yeah. Bravely Default is purely turn-based. It doesn't have as much perfect information as Chromazy 10 does, but... no ATB in that. This is my favorite limit break system, too. You have the most control over it. Basically, you can unlock different ways to build your limit break. Like, maybe you build it when you kill something, or you build it when you take damage. And you can change that per character. And it persists across battles.
Get out of my town!
Some can't wait to die.
Overdrives.
Bushido.
Look at how his thing works. It's like a fighting game input, right? Yeah, I don't like when they make blue magic. The limit break. Blue magic could stand alone, I think. I can hear that, Cappy. I think this thing only uses Demi, which reduces your hit points by a percentage of their current value. So it doesn't actually kill you. But it fills your overdrive pretty quickly. I almost screwed it up. Yeah, that could have been cool, Mega Man. This one's so good. I know your pain, man. Just beat 5 this morning. Hey, Leon. Leon, I don't know if you've seen this one before. I know you've been experiencing some Final Fantasies vicariously via stream. You haven't missed too much, though. Basically, the main character, Tidus. That's how stream voted I spell his name. Is a blitzball player, so he's like an underwater soccer player. In this futuristic city, and this horrible thing just attacked, and we're trying to get out of here. The guy I'm with, Oren, seems to know what's going on, but he's not telling the main character, Tidus, anything about it. What's up, Joe Man? Yeah, the weapon system's a little weird. It's like all upgrades, right?
What are you
right?
laughing at, old man?
Oren, let's get out of here!
We're expecting...
You mean the Teeds, right, Joe Man?
Give me a break, man!
Try to get me to say, like, Tide... The group of us over. we could just persist that as a general stream rule. If you ever hear me say, like, yeah, you know, I'll eat some pizza to tide us over. I need to start using potions, is what we're about to teach us here. Now, they're trying to teach us that sometimes enemies give you tells and you should focus those ones down first before they use a nasty attack. Ow. Yeah, the HD remake in particular, the UI in this game is super clean. There's a very polished look to it. Big fan. Just a little bit.
This could be bad.
That. Sure.
Knock it down.
What?
Trust me, you'll see.
You can mitigate the delay somewhat if you pop over to hitbox when something time appropriate happens. More like a 3-second delay. Yeah, here they're teaching us that occasionally battles will have a mechanic, which is pretty unusual for Final Fantasy games. Every now and then, but it's pretty common in these fights, I would say. Ten. The boss fights will have some kind of mechanic you can interact with. Pretty neat. Hey, M. Bubs, how you doing? Right, Matt? Yeah, I have a man crush on Orin. Man crushes are on, let's see. Harrison Ford, Idris Elba, Orin. Maybe I can come up with another one. Ah, very good. Lurk away, M-Bubs. I'll leave you be. More graphics if you're alt-tabbed. Pop in. Oh man, we're getting sucked into a giant. That's. I don't know if I want to say what that is.
You are sure?
What the hell are you doing talking to the giant space butthole, Orin? That's not a friend.
This is it.
Hey, Broken One, how you been?
It all begins here.
Cool. Alright, so now we get to experience Tidus as the uninformed protagonist. The Luke Skywalker character.
Hey!
My.
This is a interesting scene if you've beaten this game before. Oh, if I say the other thing instead of saying Tidus, and I need to give you points, like say specifically in chat, you said Tidus wrong, give us 5 points so I know what you're referencing. I'll count on the mods to keep everybody honest on that one. So the stream voted to name him Tidus, like T-E-E-D-U-S, instead of the normal spelling. And I'm offering some stream currency if anyone catches me pronouncing it correctly. I did? Alright, I'll take your word for it. And y'all are gonna, like, totally break the bank here. Right, I'll shower. Bro! What's happening?
I thought about a lot of things. Like, where I was.
Right, although it only gives 0 points to people who are in chat when I say it, not to the entire user base.
And then, sleepy. I think I had a dream. A dream.
Makes sense, Joe,
of being alone. I wanted someone, anyone, beside me. So I didn't have to feel alone anymore.
I So something I'm going to need some help with here soon is I need to go back and put between 5 and 10 timestamps on all of my YouTube videos of games we've already played. Just like saying, hey, at, you know, the 2-minute mark, we fight this boss and so on. And I can do it, but it takes a lot of time to work on. And I already have a pretty full schedule. So I might offer that as like a sphere point bounty to people. You know, you can get, I don't know, 60 sphere points for timestamping one video.
Anybody there?
I'll put the details of that together. Maybe I'll deploy that next week.
Auron! Hey!
Right, Matt? This would be a good game to come back to then, just for that reason, to see the Albed. Yeah, at a very slow pace, Broken One. We just beat 5, so I'm going to try to keep at least one Final Fantasy game on the schedule per week. It's been 2, which is a little bit much, so when we beat 9, we'll sub it out for something else, whatever takes the top vote on the upcoming games list. I've used this song in Dungeons & Dragons a few times. Good atmospheric tune. I believe this is one of the tunes that is not Nobuo Uematsu. Is the first Final Fantasy where he had, other than Tactics, where he had collaborators on the soundtrack. He did most of it. I could probably tell you if a tune is from Uematsu or not, just from having listened to it a lot. Yeah, there are some permanently missable Albed. Andrea might have some. You can go ahead and grab the ones that she has. She didn't play very far, though. It's not going to be enough for me to understand anything. Yeah, so Albed is a language that this race of characters speaks. You find primers in the game. It's a cipher. So, like, you know, a certain letter converts to another letter. But interestingly, despite it being a cipher, they actually came up with like a standard way to pronounce it, because all the voice actors actually say whatever the letters are, even if it doesn't make sense. It's kind of cool. I think that part of the way they made that work is they ensured that vowels became vowels and consonants became consonants. You can kind of pay attention to what they say. But you can get these Albed primers that translate in the subtitles what they're saying into English. You know, you can get a fair sense of what they're getting at if you have maybe half of the primers, since that's half the letters in the alphabet. Yeah, so here's an example, like...
What do we have here?
One-page children's books.
Can't read it.
Yeah, see, so like, I can't make out enough of this. Apparently Makalania is a place name because we got that whole thing. Kind of cool. If you ever play this fantastic game, it's called Charles Barkley Shut Up and Jam Gaiden, Chapter 1 of the Hoops Barkley Saga. It is a PC RPG in the style of Super Mario RPG. It's actually really well made, primarily a parody of JRPGs. But one of the things you can go in the menu in that game, like, it plays the Space Jam theme because the events of the movie Space Jam are canonical in this game. And one of the first options you can change is you can put the whole game into Albed if you want to. Figure out the cipher without primers. You could do it. There's like a newspaper puzzle you can do that's basically a cipher puzzle. It'll be like a famous quote or something, and it won't give you any hints. But you can just go, okay, well, there's, you know, these three-letter words and one-letter word, and there's only a finite number of those, so I can try out different combinations to slowly figure it out. This game, save points fully restore your HP and MP, which is just a convenience for the most part. A schedule update, we're going to be playing Final Fantasy X for another hour and 40 minutes. After which we're switching to Xenoblade Chronicles 3D. Tomorrow the schedule is going to be Xenoblade Chronicles from noon to 3, and then Final Fantasy X from 3 to 6. This week marks the debut of the sub block, which is the chance for subscribers to suggest games that they want to see. You can subscribe on Hitbox. Click below the stream for the link to that. Once you've subscribed, I can add you to that list. You can pick any one game you want to add, or you can back somebody else's game to increase its multiplier. And then whatever the top three games are at midnight tomorrow night from subscribers, we'll play those on Wednesday evening after Smash. I probably won't be grinding too much. This isn't a particularly grind-necessitating game outside of if you really want to like 100% the arena, which I likely won't do. I'd like to see some of the Dark Aeons and stuff they added to this from the international version. Yeah, I'll do that after stream, Mega Man. This is Andrea's favorite regular battle music, my wife. She makes her own bass line to it. Overkill is an excellent mechanic that I want to see in more games. I think Matt was telling me about a game that does this. Where like if the damage you deal in a single hit exceeds the enemy's maximum hit point total by a certain amount, you get an overkill bonus, which gives you extra experience at the end of the battle. Yeah, I agree, Matt. It's a quality of life feature to have save points just automatically heal you to full and remove status effects. Because right, it ultimately was just a gil sync for tents. Gil and item sync. Yeah, I might not be able to do the Dark Aeons then. Let's see. Do it, Joe Man. I'm probably going to come back to Chrono Trigger. I have the DS version. It's the one we'd probably play. I think this guy does damage based on your current hit point total. I'll use a potion real quick to test it. Hey, Burner. How you been? Burner, I got that, Ghost Pepper Griller from Taco Bell at your recommendation. It's quite good. I recommend it to people. It's slightly hotter than their mild sauce, so if you eat it, don't think that you can handle, like, actual ghost pepper salsa. Or sauce. But it's pretty good. I enjoyed it. Every Wednesday night, my wife Andrea goes out to Jazzercise. And then after Jazzercise, she gets Jazzercise-canceling Taco Bell. You know, and I have a standard order for that, and I'll be replacing one of the items in my order with the Ghost Pepper Griller, so long as it's on the menu. Cool. Chaos. Are they harder than Nemesis? The arena final battle from the original release? Hey, HDL. Other more different Nemesis. Stars. I also prefer the original version of that song. There's a couple of them. I think the biggest offender in this remastered version of the soundtrack is People of the North Pole. That was my favorite song in,
I had made it out of the frying pan.
Whenever I hear that phrase, out of the frying pan into the fire, it makes me think of The Hobbit. It was a chapter named after that.
In this place.
Cool. Is there are they the new final bosses, or is there a new arena boss that's even harder? I enjoyed fighting like the Tonberry King. I mean, if you want to do all the arena stuff endgame, there's automatic grinding because you have to collect 10 of every enemy. It takes a long time. Like, they're in the way of going back to old content? I might not do them in this playthrough. I really want to fight them.
Fire.
Final Fantasy X was one of the games that I just like played the shit out of and totally 100%ed as a kid. They made it convenient to do. Mm-hmm. Oh, I see. Right, Matt? Yeah, that's kind of messed up. Tinder. Creepy statue. You can come back here way, way later in the game. Get revenge on that first boss who scared us away there. Interesting. That's like the dog with the soggy thing in its mouth from the beginning of the game, is that right? I think I missed that in my first couple playthroughs of this game. We started Final Fantasy X. Tidus, the main character. That's how Stream has asked me to spell his name. Is a blitzball player. Blitzball is basically underwater soccer. Aquatic soccer. From this land called Xanarkin, that's very like futuristic sci-fi. And some kind of calamity happened at the beginning of the game. A monster attacked our friend Orin, who's like some kind of friend of this character's father, offered him up to the giant monster, and then he woke up here in these ruins. Doesn't know what's going on. Oh, thanks to hear it, M-Bubs. It's good to have you. That is my goal. I want to have a very chill, easygoing... Like, there's a lot of streamers who do that. Whoa, bro! Oh my god, he's making a fire! That's so crazy! Like, let's just... Stay cool. Listen while you work. And that's a cool, perfectly fine style as well. It's not my personal style. I tried to play it, Joe Man. I actually bought it to play on stream, and it was not very OBS friendly. I ended up just playing it on my PlayStation.
I need food.
This one goes to 11.
What do you want?
It was a bad call. Your team lost
nice, Joe
because
man.
Of you.
You came to say that?
It's been 10 years.
Oh, cool, Matt.
I thought you'd be crying.
Who, me?
I try not to wear this hoodie outside of the apartment anymore because it's my stream uniform and I'm wearing it already like 30 hours a week. You hear that, Joe Man?
Wait!
Get it, Tidus.
Don't go out on me! Just hold on. I'll get more wood.
A lot of cool effects in this game. This is very polished. This is the HD remaster, but even if it wasn't the HD remaster... It's having a little shine on the enemy's eye there. One thing that was a huge deal in Final Fantasy X when this game first came out that you might not appreciate today is that all the battles occur in the game world where you see the characters. Like, prior to this, you know, you had like a facsimile of the area you were in. You might be in the Crystal Dungeon, but when you got into a battle, there'd just be like this generic Crystal Dungeon background. In this one, this is literally where Tidus just was. So that was a big deal at the time. And they take advantage of that a lot, where like you'll see the battle transition where they'll be standing somewhere, and once the battle starts, they're standing exactly where they were. Yeah, if I ever do a second set, well, I guess if I do a second 7 playthrough, it'll be the remake, won't it? Nice, Matt. Yeah, if y'all can help me out, if there's something that was really exciting about 10 when it came out that we kind of take for granted today, help me to recall it. It's one of the things I like to do with this stream is point out ways games innovated. It's very easy to be jaded. That's Tara Strong, perhaps the most prolific female voice actor in Hollywood. She is Twilight Sparkle on My Little Pony. She is Timmy on Fairly Odd Parents. She is Bubbles on Powerpuff Girls. She's in just about every anime.
You're on my side? Cool.
Grenade. The pain.
Oh, damage. Steel is pretty nice in this game. It's a good way to put it, Joe, man. Nolan North's in everything, too, especially in video games. Yeah, I like this outfit better, too. Can you hear that? Fireflies. This game has an incredibly cool leveling up mechanic. I'm doing the expert sphere grid, which comes with this game. I have no idea what that looks like or how it works. I think the idea is that, unlike the normal sphere grid, everybody starts in the middle, so you can put each character in whatever direction you want. Whereas OG Final Fantasy X, like, your black mage started in the black mage section of the grid. Your white mage started in the white mage section of the grid, and so on.
Hey, let me go.
I'll see. I might just build them in unique ways. You see how they're actually phonetically pronouncing the cool cipher?
Gemid?
Fed! Trivedek Risa!
Drownia Drakisha Tain.
Ifun Petit, Fapuneket Fedrik.
Sorry, I think she says here. Kuno. Sorry.
Kuno.
Hey, Matt. The sphere grid, if you've ever played Path of Exile, Path of Exile basically has the sphere grid from 10. That's how it was sold to me originally. It's really cool. My only problem with it is it requires a lot of micromanagement. Like, if you want to be effective, you should be looking at your sphere grid after pretty much every battle. I think the whole concept of knocking somebody out isn't as we see it in media. It's a convenient storytelling trope. But I think that being knocked unconscious usually doesn't last longer than a minute or so. Thanks, brother.
Right, whatever.
Tui hood kabeg?
I said I don't understand.
Fed! He said you can stay if you make yourself useful.
You
this is kind of cool. Like, as far as the player knows, Tidus is the only person in the world who speaks his language, and everyone in the game world speaks this weird one. So it's kind of a cool way of introducing the viewer. Like, oh no, some things are still the same.
All right, I'll work.
Hey, Ventar, I've never actually played Assassin's Creed. Well, I take that back. I played a little bit of Assassin's Creed 1. I like the gameplay style. I don't know, there's something about Ubisoft games, though. They don't... Maybe somebody can help me put my finger on this or word this correctly, but they don't feel particularly polished, or they feel a little rushed, or maybe it's the fact that they have a very tight release schedule, so they're always releasing a game a year. Like, I don't know, it feels like... It's like Dynasty Warriors is a really good example of a game that's like Assassin's Creed, where, you know, you play about 2 hours of Assassin's Creed and you know what the next 20 hours of Assassin's Creed are going to be like. You play 2 hours of Dynasty Warriors, you know what the next 20 hours are going to be like. That doesn't mean that it's bad. Like, I enjoyed what I played of Assassin's Creed 1, and we'll certainly play through the series on stream at some point. Yeah, I hear you, Broken One. I was frustrated by that, too. I had a lot of things like, this isn't like old Final Fantasy. So the sphere grid, like, as you level up, you gain sphere points. Or something like that. Ability points? I don't know. You get points that let you move around the grid, that let you activate nodes. Sphere level, that's what it is. Really? Okay. Hey, Robert Nickel, how's it going? Yeah, we just beat 5. We'll play it for sure, Ventar. It'll be a blind playthrough for me of the whole series. We say Assassin's Creed 1 is like the tech demo for 2. I might not be giving it a fair shake. I've just had that experience with all of their games. Like, they're not, it's not that they're bad. Like, the Dynasty Warriors games are good games. They just feel like they define their game experience in the first, I don't know, hour or two. And then it's all variations on that. Like, okay, so I get it. I have to go do 10 versions of this hide in the crowd after assassinating somebody fetch quest, and 10 versions of this escort mission fetch quest, and so on. Awesome, Robert. Is this one of the first ones you played? I could put Assassin's Creed in the upcoming games list, or if one of the subscribers would like to add it for Subblock, I could probably get some of the earlier ones a little bit more cheaply. No, that's perfectly fine, Robert. Final Fantasy X was my wife's first Final Fantasy as well. Joe Man, right on. That's a high praise. I'm sure I'll enjoy it. No, I don't think they're bad games. I'm sorry, guys. I don't. Like, what's a better way to phrase it? Like, my friend, he'll describe a pizza that's not the best pizza in the world, but it's a really good pizza, and you get joy out of eating it. He'll call it a strong pizza. I need to have an adjective like that that means a game like Dynasty Warriors or Assassin's Creed, where it's like, yeah, it's a strong game. But I don't mean to like, take away from it when I say that it feels like an unfinished or rushed experience. Like, they're still good. I feel like those are the kinds of games where I play it for a little bit and like, okay, I get it, you know. Quality game could work. I could skip one if we play it on stream. We did that with Alright, so we have the sphere grid now. We have the advanced sphere grid, so it actually starts us somewhere different. We can decide a few different paths to take. I think it still starts you generally where you would have started otherwise. There are these locks that kind of cleverly gate you from going down a path the game doesn't want you to take too early. So, like, this is a level 1 lock. Later in the game, from, like, a predetermined boss fight, that boss will drop a level 1 lock sphere, and then we can progress past there to keep you from just grinding too much early on and getting abilities that would break the game too early. It looks like I could send Tidus down to be a white mage, which I think I kind of want to do. It would be sort of fun. Rather than putting him on his normal path of becoming what's essentially a kind of like a time mage. Yeah, a lot of his skills are very time magey. Notably, he has the most important skill in the game for a speedrunner, which is flee. And a lot of no sphere grid games, which is where you try to beat the game without activating any of these nodes, will make an exception and say that you can activate the flee sphere because it lets you leave, you know, exit battle immediately. But I think I'll go ahead and activate cheer, and I think we're gonna break the stereotype. We're gonna make our main character into a white mage, and we'll make like one of the characters who you typically would expect to be a mage into a melee fighter. We'll quickly become the Marstead stereotype. I've heard people say Black Flag is pretty awesome, but that like you shouldn't just play it without playing the other Assassin's Creeds, because then you won't be able to go back to the older Assassin's Creeds without it. I haven't seen any One Piece yet. That might be something that I do.
We found some ancient ruins.
I got a couple long flights coming up, so
it's not active now, but there should still be some power left. We're gonna go down there and activate it, and then we should be able to salvage the big prize. Okay, let's get to work.
Roger.
Really, Darkstar? That's kind of cool. It's neat to put the like ultimate abilities outside of their normal path. All right, so clearly we're like diving to salvage something. Okay, Cloud Reaver. She just punched him in the stomach. She said sorry. I mean, he doesn't really have an alternative at the moment, Leon. Like, he's clearly not at home in Xanarkand. He has no idea where he is. What's he gonna do? Let them throw him overboard? But he's kind of enslaved right now. Good God. ...704 episodes? Water levels usually freak me out. I do fine in RPGs for some reason. But like the shark in Kingdom Hearts 1 in the Little Mermaid level, like that's enough to freak me out. Yeah, they're the only three that can hold their breath for a long time, and it makes sense. Tidus and Waka, because they're Blitzball players, and I guess Riku, because she does this for a living. They don't, Cloud Reaver. They hang a lampshade on it a couple times. They're like, yeah, just hold your breath. Forever. He can't understand them, Leon. Riku can speak her language. The other ones still only speak Albed. She's just choosing to speak his language. Riku is bilingual. Is that where we're going with Cappy? The first steal is pretty much guaranteed to succeed. Yeah, you can keep stealing after that, but the chance gets lower and lower over time. I believe is how it works. You don't have to do a game that's easily emulated. If it's not, just tell me what the game is. I might already own it or have some other way to get my hands on it. But PS2 could count. I do own a lot of PS2 games. What game were you thinking of, Broken? Yeah, it's basically Magic. That overkill bonus. Mine was 4 for the Super Nintendo. After I had played Earthbound. Hey dude, Anthony, how you been? Subscriber block has been added this week. I'll post the link here. Go to the sub tab. People who have subscribed on Hitbox can add a game they'd like to see me play. And then viewers, including the subscribers, can vote on them. Whatever the top three games are on this upcoming Wednesday from 3 to 6, we'll play those games in some order. In the event that no votes come in and people just list their games, I'll choose them randomly. Robert. It's pretty complex, and it requires a bit of micromanagement. The sphere grid. Yeah, so, unlike other Final Fantasies, because it's all done, rendered in 3D, they can do events in the combat like this. Trigger commands. One, 5, 4, 6, 2, 3, 9, 14. Right on. Oh, so you haven't played 10, Kami. Right on. Heck yeah. Blizzard Wizard. Probably have Tidus potion him up in his turn. Well, I guess if they. Oh, he used pincer attack. Let's see that. Cool, HDL. Who'd you join? Now, 11 was a very different game. Different time. We stopped them from moving away from us now, and I think the person who's attacking right behind does extra damage. Ow. Whack! Look at that. Critical. Had to steal again, but no, we lucked out. Burner, I'm trying to keep it spoiler-free. There are some folks in chat who haven't played it, but you can speak in code about it. Thank you for asking. I'll point out some things that are important to notice now that will come up later. Cool, sounds good, HCL. I had a PlayStation only for Final Fantasy VII. My parents scrimped and saved for a long time. Get it for me. I was eternally grateful. No, probably not. Can't really think of any character names that are spoilers. I mean, they show you your full party at the very beginning of the game, right? the in media res opening where you're all sitting around a fire. I guess saying where they were when they were sitting around that fire would be a pretty big spoiler. But saying their names, I don't really care. Right, Matt. I enjoy that about this game. This game has my favorite party switching mechanic in that you can switch party in the middle of combat and it doesn't like take up a turn or anything. It's like Paper Mario when you get the quick switch badge. Very, very convenient. Yes, I'll do Fire Emblem. Fire Emblem Awakening's actually on the vote list for the next game to replace Final Fantasy IX. Currently doesn't have very many votes. It is at... did a count last night. It is at 2 votes. You can spend 60 sphere points per vote, or 48 sphere points if you're a subscriber on Hitbox, to bump that up if you really want to see it sooner on stream. Basically, when we beat Final Fantasy IX, whatever game has the most votes at midnight that day will be the one that subs in to replace it. Right now, Secret of Evermore is in the lead with 42 votes. It becomes pretty easy to farm them, though, later, Mega Man. You can, if you choose to just not use them. I am a great sinner. I have never used Waka in this game. Never, ever, ever. Even though he's really good at, like, he has really high accuracy, he almost never misses.
Hoof, roof to Tunga Deep. Way, Wicheta!
Hey! Hey,
I will do some of it, Robert, but anything that requires excessive grinding, I probably won't do. So I won't fight Nemesis. I'll do, like, the Omega Dungeon. You can do that without doing too much grinding. I'll make a token attempt at, like, Lulu's ultimate weapon.
Hungry.
Tidus's ultimate weapon, and so on. Yeah, see, they all still speak Albed, but she is bilingual.
Whoa! Right on.
Right on. Don't kill yourself, man. We haven't met him yet, HCL. I'm very conscious of it now, Joe, man. I've already given out 10 sphere points.
It's because you eat too fast.
I don't know, Cappy. I just didn't use them. Didn't need to. If Dark Aeons are even harder, then probably not.
Hello there. What is your name?
Riku.
Whoa! You really do understand. Woo-hoo-hoo! Huh? Why didn't you say so earlier?
I didn't get a chance to. Everyone thought we were a fiend.
We?
Oh, we means you.
I don't know how they did Albed in Japanese. It makes sense because there's like 26 primers in English, one for each of the letters of the English alphabet.
We're Albed. Can't you tell? Wait. You're not an Albed hater, are you?
I don't even
know
what
this is.
Yeah,
this is the HD remake.
Where are you from?
Gratuitous booty shot.
I'm a blitzball player. Star player of the Xanarkin Abes.
Did you hit your head or something?
You guys hit me?
Oh, right. Do you remember anything before that?
So I told her everything there was to tell about Xanarkin. About life there,
Miranda/Riku.
Blitzball, and Sin's attack. And about how Aran and I were engulfed in this light. I just said things as they came to mind. But then I started to wonder.
Does Waka's Limit Break have multiple hits or something? That's usually what determines the most powerful character. Who can hit the most times
in
one turn.
Say something funny?
You were near Sin.
Mm-hmm.
Don't worry, you'll be better in no time. They say your head gets funny when Sin is near.
What's wrong with
my
head?
Just had some kind of dream?
You mean I'm sick?
Because of Sin's toxin, yeah.
You sure?
Yeah,
what?
There is no Zanarkand anymore. Sin destroyed it 1,000 years ago. So no one plays blitzball there.
Huh? What do you mean?
Okay, so first of all, I really like the ambiguity this creates of like, wait, is Tidus really from Zanarkand? Or was he just affected by Sin's toxin? And is he just like waking up and has this hallucination? Who knows? We'll find out.
But I saw Sin attack Zanarkand. You're saying that happened 1,000 years ago? No way.
Gives you one last chance. There's an Albed primer that's usually here, but I loaded it in from Andrea's save. They give you a chance to carry over your Albed primers when you find these little compilations here, so you can do like a second playthrough of the game where you understand Albed in the subtitles. Tidus still doesn't.
You said
you're
a blitzball?
Uh-huh.
You know, you should go to Luca. Someone might know who you are, or you might find someone you recognize.
Luca?
Huh. Okay, leave it to me. I'll get you to Luca.
You're looking out, Riku.
You'd rather stay here? Okay,
they haven't done a close zoom on her face, really, but,
Oh. And one thing. Don't tell anyone you're from Zanarkand, okay? Yevon says it's a holy place. You might upset someone.
Riku and the other Albed have weird eyes. They have, like, spiral eyes. So, usually they'll be wearing goggles.
My Zanarkand? Some kind of holy place? Yeah, right, I thought. Since when?
I haven't, Kami. You're welcome to post them.
Yevon?
I'll get
Sin,
some of them, Burner.
Luca? I thought
like
Sin
I'll
just took
make
me to a faraway place.
Honest attempt at Lulu's. I've done it before.
I could go back in a day or two. But 1,000 years.
I'll probably set a time limit on each legendary weapon attempt, though. Like, I won't do more than 30 minutes or an hour or so.
Whoa!
Riku's is pretty easy to get. As is Kamara, I think. I do really like the grind. I've like sunk a couple hundred hours into this game in the past. I think a lot of it would be too fun to watch though. Maybe we'll bring it back. Come in the sub block. Marsh said grinds the end of Final Fantasy X. That looks pretty good, Kami. When did these get posted? Was this, how recently was this? You meant 15. That or Boko got an extreme upgrade. And he meant Zoolander too. Met Knight at the Roxbury. 15.
Riku!
Ow! Schedule update. We're playing Final Fantasy X for another 1 hour. and then switching to Xenoblade Chronicles 3D.
Blitzball!
Hey, you okay?
You'll recognize Waka's voice actor.
Hey!
Maggio. Voice of Bender in Futurama. And many, many other things. Graphics. I've done it before, Robert. Never in the international version, though, so I haven't seen any of the crazy extra content from that. I wanted it when I was a kid and was playing the shit out of this game. Yeah, I agree, this is a very pretty game.
Yo. Hiya.
You wanna try that move one more time?
Finally.
Hi.
Things were starting to look up.
Bender's a genius. Yeah, so whenever I tell my wife I love her, I say, I love you, Andrea. She doesn't say I love you too. She says, she quotes Bender and says, shut up, baby, I know it.
You know
you're gonna get a lot of Bender's voice actor in this game.
The Xanarchan Abes.
Yes, he is, Joe Man, John DiMaggio. I have Chaos. Everyone should see I Know That Voice. It is a free documentary on Netflix. You will enjoy it. It has all the voice actors you know and love, including most of the voice actors in this game. Tara Strong is in it. James Arnold Taylor, who's Tidus, is in it. John DiMaggio paid for it and directs it. It's very good. Remember, he was upset because he mentioned that he played for the Xanarchan Abes. And the Xanarchan is apparently a holy place now.
I got too close to Sin, and my head's all foggy-like. So, I don't know where this place is. Or even where I came from.
Sin's toxin got to you. But you're still alive. Praise be to Yeren. All right, back to practice. I'm Waka.
Yeah, I actually need to give stream 5 sphere points if you catch me saying Titus, the correct pronunciation.
What? You hungry? Okay, back to the village. I'll get you something.
Blitzball. Not the best blitzers in Spira. The world name is Spira. It's our first time hearing that term. Actually, they call him Tidus in Kingdom Hearts 1. He has a cameo appearance along with Selphie from Final Fantasy VIII and Waka. The voice actress of Selphie calls him Tidus, and it drove me crazy when I was a kid because I never pronounced it that way. Waka. I think they corrected it. I think Tidus has another. And every time I say Tidus, it's a very conscious move by me because that's not how I usually pronounce it. They corrected the pronunciation in Kingdom Hearts 2. That'd be too.
I felt like I could trust this Waka, so I just had to ask.
It's true Xanarchan was destroyed, right? 1,000 years ago? So it's just a big pile of rubble now, isn't it?
Long time ago, there were a whole lot of cities in Spira. Big cities with machina, machines to run them. People played all day and let the machina do the work. And then, well, take a look. Sin came and destroyed the machina cities. And Xanarchan along with him. Yeah, that was about 1,000 years ago, just like you said. If you ask me, Sin's our punishment for letting things get out of hand. What gets me, though, is we gotta suffer because of what some goofballs did way back when. Of course, we must always repent for our sins. That's
yeah, Matt, it's like the episode where he gets the upgrade and he's on the island with the non-technological robots.
It was just as Riku said. Waka and Riku couldn't both be lying.
The robot with the water wheel that needs to go run in the ocean every few minutes to stop from powering down forever.
But you from the Zanuck and Daves, that was a good one, huh? Hey, I'm not saying that team never existed, yeah? But you gotta figure, a team living in luxury like that be pretty soft, eh?
I appreciated the fact that Waka was trying to cheer me up. But at that time, all I could think about was everything that happened to me. All this.
Yeah, don't post any spoilers about the game if you know what happens.
Maybe if I could find Sin one more time, I could go home. For now, I'd just live life until that time came. No more worrying about where or when I was. Sure, it was hard not to think of home, but I started to feel better already. A little better. Maybe.
I have played this before, many times, but there's some people in chat who haven't, so I'm trying to preserve the virgin experience for them. Exactly, Kami. Great part of the end of that episode where he's like, wait, is my entire existence someone else's dream?
Hey,
I possibly, nay, probably the product of someone else's imagination? No, get out. Next. Is it life after love or love after love? I see it working either way. Man, Waka, I ain't even trying to hear that. Smacking me in the booty.
What's the big idea?
Pretty water effects. Man, Waka time. Eat it, fish. I really love the UI in this game. It's extremely polished. It was that way in the original as well, but more so in the HD version. Yeah, Robert, I have the same opinion. It's the only Final Fantasy I feel that way about. I mean, eventually it's going to have to cap out. It's never going to surpass 6. But I had a pretty low opinion of it when I played it the very first time in comparison to the earlier games, and I've just enjoyed it more. It's to be appreciated, I think. It's very different in a lot of ways. So now that we're in Spira, we're officially in the more Eastern culture. Whereas almost every other Final Fantasy is very Western in style. European, medieval, or Western sci-fi. Sure, I will use Waka. Because I have not in the past. But as Cappy pointed out, there's no excuse not to use him because you can switch out party members in combat. Agree, Matt. Jinx, I think, reduces their luck stat. Actually, don't know what luck does in this game. Probably has to do with steal rates. Hey, Topher, how you been? Good to see you again. Not really to the end game. This game's pretty well balanced. The end game is a totally different beast. Like, the end game is all about dealing 99,999 damage per hit and doing it multiple times on a turn. And or using quick hit to attack so many times that the enemy doesn't even get a turn. Ixion's pretty cool. Actually has a unique Aeon to this game. Doing alright. Excited to be playing 10 again. Been a while. Waka has a dark attack option that blinds the enemy. Whack. don't know if there are any other chests in the water here. I'll just keep moving forward. Probably not going to do too much grinding. This game doesn't really demand it. Except if you want to do the optional stuff in the end game. You can beat this whole game without really ever using the sphere grid.
Got a favor to ask you.
Called an NSG or no sphere grid run.
You want me on your team, right?
Yeah, I definitely prefer Ramu. Evasion and critical hit? Right on, Robert.
A major blitz tournament.
Is reducing the luck of an enemy the same as increasing your own crit rate?
It's so huge, I'm sure someone there will recognize you. Then, you can go back to your old team, right? It'll be fun. What do you say, huh? Come on, come on.
Sure thing.
Dude, our team is gonna rock, eh?
I actually haven't played the Fire Emblem from which Marth originates. I've only played,
I thought then that Blitzball and Sin were the only two things that Spira
Awakening.
And Zanarkand had in common. I wasn't too far off, either.
Tidus is narrating this game from that in media res scene at the very beginning, where him and his allies were sitting around a campfire. So when you hear him doing that voiceover.
This is where I was born. I started Blitz when I was 5. I joined the Aurochs at 13, 10 years ago. 10 years, and we never won a game. Well, after last year's tournament, I quit. Time seemed right.
That's good to know.
So, after quitting, I got this new job, yeah? But every time my mind wandered, I thought about the game.
10 years without a single win will do that.
My first match last year was my big chance. But something else was on my mind. I couldn't focus.
Nice excuse.
Hey!
So, you want to win the next tournament? Go out with a bang. So, what's our goal?
I don't care how we do. Long as we play our best. If we give it our all, I can walk away happy.
No. If I say, what's our goal, you say, victory! When you play in a Blitzball tournament, you play to win.
Victory? You're serious?
Isn't the infamous ha 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 scene, like, even worse in the Japanese version? What I've heard.
Ah, the one from the sea.
Be on guard. There are fiends on the road today.
After surviving your run-in with Sin, it would be a shame if something happened now.
Who are they?
Luzu and Gata, Crusaders.
Huh? Crews of what?
What, you forgot that too? Hey, sorry. Don't worry about it. I'll help you out.
Cool. In return, come tournament time, I'll make sure we take the cup.
Cool. About the Crusaders, you can ask them yourself. They got a lodge in a village.
Kami, you're worse than the Japanese version. Right, Cappy? Most Final Fantasy characters only appear in one Final Fantasy, Gilgamesh aside.
Be saved, village!
They got any food there?
We'll get you something over there later. Take a look around first. Let's see. The Crusader's Lodge is over yonder. Luzu and Gata are usually there. Alright. Over here.
Huh? What's up?
You do remember the prayer, right?
Of course I'd never prayed before in my life. Not that he would know that.
You must have forgot or something. Here, I'll show you. Go ahead, you try. Okay, now, go present yourself to the temple summoner.
Any blitzball player would know that prayer. It was the blitzball sign for victory.
I hate you, Asakara. I've never gotten it quickly. When you try to get Tidus's ultimate weapon, this course that you run, basically, there are these birds that spawn. If they crash into you, they reduce your time. You're trying to get a time that's less than 0 seconds, right? So if a bird hits you, it adds to your time, and if you pop these balloons, it reduces your time. But the spawns of the birds and the balloons are not static. They're totally random. So you could play it perfectly and just get unlucky stream of birds or just get not enough balloons over and over. I've spent hours and hours before trying to get it. That's pretty nasty. They've redone almost all of the pre-rendered scenes. They're very pretty. Like, this is a pre-rendered background here. Most of it is a fully 3D environment, but a lot of these towns where, like, the camera doesn't move. You go in a shop. Nah, lightning's no problem. You just gotta go zen for lightning, Robert. Just take a deep breath. Be patient. I've gotten to 197 lightning strikes before. You have to get 200 consecutive lightning strikes. Basically, the screen flashes white, and you have to press the confirm button to dodge it. You have to do that 200 times in a row. You have a very short frame window to press the button. If you miss it even once, you have to start over. I've done that a couple times. This is the HD remake, Coach. Which is better in a lot of ways, although I don't like the soundtrack changes. It's the same soundtrack, they've just remastered it, so they use new instruments, and a lot of the tunes suffer for it, I think.
Hey, you! You were attacked by Sin, right? Recently, was it?
I think so.
So, Sin can't be far, right? You're not hiding anything, are you?
Why would I?
If Sin's nearby, it'll attack the island for sure. But it hasn't. I wonder why.
I'm sorry. I really don't know anything. To tell the truth, I don't even know what the Crusaders are.
You're kidding, right?
Sin, the toxin. Gotta tell him who we are.
Yes, sir. The Crusaders are sworn to battle Sin. We have chapters throughout Spira, accepting all who wish to join our struggle. The hero Mihen formed the Crusaders 800 years ago as the Crimson Blades. Later, our ranks grew and we called ourselves the Crusaders. We've been fighting Sin ever since.
What? You've been fighting 800 years and you still haven't beat it?
Well, we've steered Sin away from towns many times. And that's all we can do. Nobody's ever been able to defeat it. Our mission as Crusaders is to protect the temples, towns, villages, and people of Spira.
So, then whose job is it to defeat Sin?
Is Sin's toxin really this bad, sir?
It does seem rather bad.
Again, Tidus here is serving as an audience surrogate. They need to explain these rules about the universe to us as a player. They need to have a character that can do that. Sometimes they cheat that by the character having amnesia. Maybe Tidus has amnesia? Again, we're not spoiling what's going on for anybody in chat. Who knows what his deal is, but he clearly doesn't know what the deal is with Spira and needs people to explain it to him. It's like Fry waking up in the year 3000 in Futurama.
We could just tell you, but I think it better for you to try and remember. Go pray at the temple. Perhaps Yevon will help you regain your memory.
Oh, believe me, I wanted to come out tomorrow, but I'm not holding my breath. I've been hurt too many times. It's like when a new Sonic game gets announced, I don't get excited anymore. Unless if they say it's going to be 2D. A tutorial thing here, I think.
But soon, we may be able to finally defeat Sin. We've got a plan, one that'll go down in Crusader history.
When the 7 remake comes out, I'll do a 24-hour stream for that one. I'll pick it up at midnight and just play it until I pass out and keep doing that till we beat it.
We've been excommunicated from Yevon. We must go, now. Everything is riding on our next, our last.
I think the fundamental problem is that Sonic doesn't translate to 3D. It's all about moving quickly, and 3D is all about designing these, like, intense landscapes. I don't know. I don't think you could make a good 3D Sonic game. Unless if it's Sonic Adventure, which it really isn't a Sonic game. It's still fun. I enjoy it. But it's fundamentally different from the older Genesis titles. I haven't played Galaxy 2, I've only played the first one. Sup, Wox?
Go present yourself to the temple summoner before we eat, yeah?
Waka flocka. Yeah, that's like action adventure. Which is fine, I love the Sonic Adventure games. They're good games and they'll be on the stream eventually. By that token. But I feel like Sonic Adventure is to Sonic as Super Mario RPG is to Mario. It features a character named Sonic, and, you know, he moves pretty quickly. Right, Kami. Yeah, whenever you do have to do any kind of platforming, you're right, it's very, very slow. What's Sanarkand? What's Yevon? Visions of Yevon are the only salvation of those who suffer because of sin. Go pray at the temple. Sure. You should do it, Daskara. We'll do 10-2 on stream. I don't think we'll do it right after 10. I think I might jump back to Final Fantasy 1, Dawn of Souls. Bring it back though. Hymn of the Faith is one of the first things I learned to play on piano. Has not been remastered because they can't just pull up a Casio and play it out.
Standing in that place. I began to realize how different this world was from my own.
This is remarkably Asian aesthetic in here. Whereas Tidus's was more of a Western sci-fi. Broska is watching over our apprentice somewhere. Hey, Mind for Fish, how you been?
10 years have passed since Lord Broska became High Summoner. And finally, we receive a statue for our temple.
Well, what's a high summoner? I got too close to Sin's, toxin.
It was funny hearing myself make the same excuse over and over. Funny, and a little sad.
The summoners are practitioners of a sacred art, sworn to protect the people of Yevon. Only a chosen few become summoners, who call forth entities of great power, the Aeons. The Aeons hear our prayers and come down to us. They are the blessing of Yevon.
So what he meant was that we should respect some kind of great men or something like that, I figured.
Only sworn guardians may enter the Cloister of Trials. I like cloisters, I like trials. So there's statues of what appear to be four high summoners here. There's like a mascot job at the end game, it's like a mimic, right? Gunner's the OP one, right? You get the catnip thing that lets you shoot a whole bunch of times. This is another remastered, pre-rendered background. They basically had to redraw the entire background, otherwise it wouldn't have stretched. Catnip, that's what it was. Very, very Asian. This temple. Let's go talk to Waka and see what's going on. So I'm going to be quiet during a lot of the voice acting in this game, so I'm not clashing with when they're speaking, so I'll just be typing in chat if there's a lot of active voice acting.
Sorry, man. No time for lunch yet. Take a nap. You look pushed.
Yeah, let's do it. Napping it up.
You could at least go see how they are doing.
We can't interfere. It's a rule.
But it's been nearly.
I'm having another dream about Xanarkand.
But it's been nearly.
It's been nearly a day already.
Perhaps you could go look for us.
People are searching for him now.
Thank you.
Assume they're talking about Jekt here. Yeah.
Who cares whether he comes back or not?
But he might die.
Fine, let him.
Do you hate him so? But if he dies, you'll never be able to tell him how much you hate him.
So there you go. Critical to Tidus's arc. He has daddy issues. We know very little about it at the moment, though. Waka was summoned to the temple for some reason. Let's go find out why. Interesting. Well, what Final Fantasy characters have an interpersonal relationship problem? Not Cecil, really. Cecil's more of an internal struggle. Not Bartz, really. Terra is more of an internal struggle. Terra versus the world, kind of a thing. Cloud is definitely internal.
Is something wrong?
Squall's very internal. Zidane's very internal. From the trial.
Eh?
Well, apprentice summoner, really.
Huh?
There's a room in there called the Cloister of Trials. Beyond is where the apprentice summoner prays. If the prayer is heard, the apprentice becomes a fully fledged summoner. Remember?
So someone is in there somewhere and they haven't come back out. Right, I got it.
A day's already gone by.
Is it particularly dangerous in there?
Sometimes, yes.
Why don't you go in and help?
There's already guardians in there.
Yeah, I guess his primary arc. Zidane becomes pretty external.
Hey, but what if something happens?
In the You're Not Alone sequence.
Dies?
The precepts must be obeyed.
Like I care.
But almost, I'd say, Tidus' entire arc throughout this game is a lot to do with him and his relationship with his dad. Spoilers. That continues to be important.
Maybe this wasn't such a good idea after all.
Schedule update. We're going to be playing Final Fantasy X for another 30 minutes. Then we're switching to Xenoblade Chronicles 3D. We'll play that from 3 to 6. I'll take a short break at 3 to feed the cats, run to the restroom, that kind of stuff. Vaughn doesn't count as a protagonist. Vaughn is a camera. If you played Final Fantasy XII, he's like, if you've read the Game of Thrones books, he's a Arya Hota. He's just there to give insight to the characters that matter, that are the actual protagonists of the game. I'd say Bosch is very external. Bosch and Ash. Let's use a sphere to go further. Glyph spheres open the way to the Chamber of the Faith. Destruction spheres open the way to hidden treasure. Sounds good. I only carry one sphere at a time. Put this back just in case it does anything. It might not. Just makes a little glyph. Yeah, that's a pretty big nerf, Mega Man. Talking about Final Fantasy X-2, there's an item that trivializes the endgame quite a bit. Does the door stay open if I do that? It does. Nice. Do anything? Does. Alright. Secret tunnel. And there's a destruction sphere. Every temple has a destruction sphere that you can use to get to a secret item. If you find all the destruction sphere items, you unlock something secret at the end of the game. All of them can be revisited, except for one, but I believe the one temple that's impossible to revisit, it's also impossible to screw it up. Like, part of the main mission is using a destruction sphere and getting the related chest. Set that down for a second. It's pretty strong. Hey, Andrea. I added A as a name, as well as Tyler. The vote was for Tidus, T-E-E-D-U-S, the main character's name. And I have to pay out 5 sphere points to stream if I accidentally call him anything other than Tidus. Rod of Wisdom. That hidden item. So there's something you unlock at endgame if you get all those. The song hasn't changed very much from the original incarnation. Yeah, puzzle solved. Alright, let's head down. Kami.
Hey!
I roll my eyes every time I say Tidus.
Hey, it's okay. Only summoners, apprentice summoners, and their guardians can enter here. It's a tradition, very important.
So what about you?
Me? I'm a guardian.
A guardian?
Hawke's like, yeah, that's what I said.
Summoners go on a pilgrimage to pray at every temple in Spira. Guardians protect them. The guardian's in there now. One of them's got a short fuse, and who knows what the other's thinking. Well, now that we've come this far, might as well go all the way.
What are you doing here? Didn't think we'd be able to handle it.
No, it's just... See, I told you she gets mad easy.
Is the summoner all right?
Who
are get some
you?
Graphics here soon. Yeah, I could get another full motion video cutscene. If you're alt-tab, you don't want to tab in to see it. Graphics in this game are very well done. D-Rock. Here come the graphics. I feel like Tetsuya Nomura's answer to clothes is like, just add more belts. Unnecessary, superfluous zippers. Oh man, she's a heterochromat. Her eyes are different colors. A fancy way to say that. Yeah, it's a really cool scene. Man, back in the day, that's how you used to play these Japanese RPGs. You get really excited for the pre-rendered full motion video cutscenes. Less important
Fan
these
was
days.
I surprised. And here I was thinking summoners were all old geezers.
Oh, Koji, you're talking about the ha 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 scene? Ha ha ha. I thought Koji was talking about the scene we just saw. Alright, Broken One, points for Shenmue.
Hey, over here.
I'm excited to play that game. It's the most amazing, most boring game ever made. So rad.
What? Ow!
Wait till you see this.
I can't see anything.
Ready.
Okay.
Right, Mega Man? Stay away from the summoner! Mega Man, you beat me to it. I was about to say that. Stay away from the summoner! Oh man. This is a unique summon to Final Fantasy X, Val 4. You do get some classics in this game. A couple new ones. They always try to add new ones in each game. Yeah, exactly, Mega Man. Stay away from the summoner. Ride the Shoopuff. Yeah, any voice acting you hear multiple times burned into my brain. Yes, you'll be naming all the Aeons. I'll set that up here. You guys want to start, Impossible.
I had never seen anything like it in my life. Sure, it was a little scary, but still, I could feel a strange kind of gentleness coming from it.
Well, you pretty much need to have Shiva and Ifrit. Herd dragon. If you've just joined the stream and you don't have any sphere points yet, if you follow, there's a little bit of a scam to give you, get a bonus 100 sphere points if you click follow that you can spend right now if you want to. Or you can just vote once. So we got bird dragon, birdman, fish, birdie, Titus. And Cappy made me say it. So you guys get some sphere points, jerk. That's messed up, Cappy. Awesome, good. Yeah, this is a really good Final Fantasy. Right, Leon? That's the cat shit is a reference when we did our playthrough of Final Fantasy VII. Kate Sith, we had stream vote on his name and ended up going with cat shit, I think, was what people voted for. All right, I think that's good enough. I'll go ahead and send out the vote. I'll put Valifor in there, too. Six is my favorite Final Fantasy, but 10, every time I play it, it climbs up the list. I appreciate it more and more. So it's unique in a lot of ways. It added a lot of things to the series. It has my favorite combat system of any Final Fantasy. And I really like just the raw turn-based, no ATB, perfect information style. And I like that it has this very, you know, Asian, Eastern, Japanese quality, whereas a lot of the Final Fantasies are more of like a Victorian, European, medieval, Western style or a Western sci-fi style. So it's pretty unique. All right now Birdman has 2 votes. Cat shit, bird, dragon, fish, and birdie all have 1 vote. I can see about in the future re-adding a display of this thing. See if I can just do that right now on the fly. 1 second. Display the current votes on the stream. Try to remove this when it's done. Alright, Bird Dragon is at 25. You can spend sphere points. I can see if Bird Dragon will fit. If it doesn't, I can try to make it fit. Doesn't look like it will, so I would have to do like Bird Dragon, like that. Yeah, bird dragon. Damn it, Cappy. I'm gonna set the timer going for 40 seconds here. Be careful not to say its name. Right, Darkstar. Ooh, Birdman. 151. Birdman it is. Birdman. You seen Rick and Morty with Bird Person? Yeah, look at that vote snipe there.
I remember.
I accept
that
this.
Night, we talked for the first time. I didn't know it then, but after that night,
there's a new episode of Rick and Morty last night. It's pretty funny.
For everyone.
for me. Harvey Birdman. Birdman. You're good, Chaos. Got a sniper.
Let me introduce you to the team. This guy here wants into the tournament so bad, I let him on the team. His memory's a little fuzzy, so don't mind him if he says anything odd. Come on, say hi.
Hi, guys. So what's our goal?
To do our best!
Nope, we got a new goal now. Our new goal is victory! To win every match, defeat every opposing team. To bring the
I said Kate
said
the pronunciation is supposed to be catchy because it's Gaelic.
That's all we need
Gaelic.
To do to win. Easy, huh?
Victory!
All variations of Titus is pretty funny too.
Victory! Yeah!
The Auroch is a prehistoric ancestor of the ox. Like it was like a super ox, basically. I think it was prehistoric. I don't know if Aurochs existed as like in the last 6,000 years during human life and went extinct more recently. They're a very large ox. That's all you need to know. I think the word ox comes from oryx, like the end of oryx sounds like ox.
You sure got the boys worked up, huh?
You heathen!
Stay away from the summoner!
You're a bad man!
Lady Yuna, be careful.
But it was really my fault to begin with. I'm Yuna. Thank you so much for your help earlier.
Huh? I'm sorry about that. Wasn't I not supposed to... Guess I kind of overreacted.
Oh, no. I was overconfident.
I saw that Aeon thing. That's amazing.
Really? Do you think I can become High Summoner?
Lady Yuna, come play with me some more.
I hear you, Kush. Is it Kujayun? Am I pronouncing that right?
So,
I know I was saying Koj before.
Tomorrow, then.
Tomorrow?
We're going on the same boat, aren't we?
Oh, really?
We can talk more.
Huh.
You can tell me all about Xanarkand.
Yuna is a Hedy Burris. She's a less prolific voice actress, but she's in a lot.
She's cute, yeah?
Oh, man. This doesn't actually matter. There's not, like, a Barret date in this game. I think it kind of comes up. You can, like, focus yourself in one direction or the other. I think I'm going to go with the canon, like... Titus likes Yuna.
Don't get no ideas.
No promises there, big guy. Hey, but what if she, like, comes on to me?
That's not going to happen. If you get tired, let me know. I had a bed made for you.
Yeah, if they let you rename any other characters, they don't because they want to refer to them with the voice acting. They still haven't found a solution to that. Well, I guess the solution they've gone with in most modern games, I think in this one they just, like, try to call Titus, hey, you, or like, oh, it's our newest guardian. But nowadays they'll, like, give him a last name, so you have, like, Shepherd or Hawk or the Inquisitor. You know, they'll come up with a name to call you when they're referring to you directly.
Stay away from the summoner!
Stay away.
Stay away from the summoner!
You have to do this at least 3 times.
Stay away from the summoner! Stay away from the summoner! Stay away from the summoner!
Ready for bed. Good.
Sleep tight.
Stay away from the summoner. Yeah, it's Tidus, you know, like you wash your clothes with teed cold water. Right. Ride the shoe puff? And more flashbacks.
Where's that boat?
Everyone will find us if it doesn't come soon.
You really sure this is okay?
Would you take me to Xanarkand?
Hey! You said you'd go with me!
Oh, hey,
I thought Waka told you not to get any ideas.
He did?
Love triangle.
Yeah, so you're coming with me.
Hey, stop dreaming!
You with a woman? You can't even catch a ball!
Oh, what's the matter?
Gonna cry again. Cry, cry. That's the only thing you're good for.
I hate you.
Huh? What'd you say?
You have to speak loudly.
I hate you!
Huh?
That's the spirit. You can do it.
Hate your dad.
I hate you!
Jack is such a cool name, too. Okay. Dead. This is important. Graphics.
He does look a lot like Chapu. I was surprised, too, the first time I saw him. But no matter what he looks like, he isn't Chapu. You shouldn't have brought him here in the first place.
Yeah, but... he needed our help.
Excuses again?
Yeah, but...
that's it. No more. Enough, Waka.
Lulu, Vivi. But you submit that Jekt is a cool name.
Scary. So, who's Chapu?
My little brother, Chapu. Looked like you.
He's dead?
We've seen Tidus's mom a couple times coming in his flashbacks.
Fought Sin last year.
But it's about Jekt.
He didn't make it.
He doesn't have a name.
I first heard on the day of the tournament.
Oh, so that's why.
I became a guardian to fight Sin, yeah?
Revenge, then?
That was the idea. I'm more worried about a stupid game now than avenging my brother. Well, after the next tournament, I'll be a guardian full-time. I know it kinda looks like I'm using you, but I'm not.
Don't worry. I mean, I owe you a lot. You really helped me out, you know? What I mean is... thanks, Waka.
Stop. You're embarrassing me.
Oh, Tidus's mom's... I mean, her name was generic NPC, right? That was like her maiden name. She looks like all the other generic NPCs. To Kami's point. Alright, so we learned something fairly important there, right? That Tidus looks, he's like the spitting image of Waka's dead brother, Chapu, who apparently died, Sin killed him. So make you wonder, is that just a coincidence? Is it? I don't know, man. You got this guy, he wakes up, he's all amnesiac. He thinks he's from Xanarkand because he got too close to Sin, and he happens to look just like Waka's brother. What's the deal? Cool, D-Rock, me too. Alright, I'm not going to get to the next save point in 3 minutes, so I'm going to go ahead and we'll take this time to get Xenoblade Chronicles 3D set up. I also have to take a couple minute break to go feed the cats. If you're just here for Final Fantasy X, that's cool. We are going to be playing more of it. The goal of this stream is to complete one full playthrough of every awesome game ever made, knowing that that's an impossible task, but we're going to try anyway. Final Fantasy X is one of those games. We just beat Final Fantasy V today. X will be returning tomorrow from 3 to 6 Pacific, and then we'll be playing more of it the following weeks, usually on Mondays and Tuesdays. You can check below the stream to see the schedule. But if you're also here for other games, Xenoblade Chronicles is a cool one. It's the game that Shulk is from if you played the new Smash Brothers, and we'll be starting it in about 4 or 5 minutes after I take care of feeding the cats. So I'll throw up the BRB and we'll be back shortly. I want Xenoblade Chronicles X really bad. Xenoblade's already extremely pretty. And that's just seeing it on the new 3DS. Okay, we'll be back. Thanks for the follow, Random. Good looking out last week, too. I appreciate that. Now, there's a couple people who are trying to avoid Xenoblade spoilers who are playing it themselves. We're maybe 60% of the way through the game. And if you watch today and you're trying to avoid spoilers, you're not going to avoid them. Even if we just focus on side quests, there's something about our party right now that's a pretty big spoiler. So I'll give you a minute or two if you wanted to bounce to avoid those.